This is the sixth of the rows, 32, and this one's kind of a bear, actually. So let me talk about how I go about learning stuff like this that's got a lot of notes in it, especially when it's just like non-stop 16th notes. So first of all, one of these is your best friend. So I love my Dr. B. I've had this since I was in high school, and it's been thrown against walls. It's been thrown downstairs, and it keeps on ticking. Ha ha ha. So anyway, this thing is great because you have to have a metronome. It's terrific to have one that actually you can tap the tempo you want, but whatever. This is not a commercial for Dr. Beat. So what you do is you start this thing, you start your metronome at the slowest, most pedantic, I can totally play this in my sleep tempo. Something like this. Etc. If you can't play it at that tempo, you play it slower. And you play it all the way through to a logical section here. There are a couple of places where there's like a whole bar rest. So, you know, the whole idea is you want to be able to play those whole sections, okay? And you want to be able to play them perfectly. You do not want to, you know, practice messing up. As you're practicing it, you go through the whole thing, you play it once or twice, and then you move your metronome up 5 beats per minute, and you do it again. And you move your metronome up 5 beats per minute, and you do it again, and again, and again. Now, you may run out of face to be able to do all this in one setting. No problem. Come back the next day. You're going to find, usually, that the tempo that you left off at, you can't actually play the next day. You're going to need to go back 5 or maybe even 10 beats per minute and work yourself back up. But it's kind of like, you know, you're pushing a rock uphill. It's going to roll back a little bit the next day. So definitely you have to use a metronome. And the second part of practicing something like this is what I call Tarzan notes. So I'm going to have to explain what that means a little bit here. When you're playing something that's straight 16th notes, you need to find places for your brain and your fingers to collect themselves, right? So what do I mean by that? You pick notes in the midst of these long phrases that you kind of hold a little bit longer than the rest of the notes that are around it. Let me demonstrate what I mean by that. So I'm going to choose certain notes. I'm going to really exaggerate what I'm talking about. And the whole idea is you the whole Tarzan reference is that you swing from these, I'm going to call them anchor notes. You swing from these anchor notes and your brain collects itself, and then you swing to the next anchor note and play the notes in between it. So these anchor notes are the ones that you hold a little bit longer. So now I'll demonstrate. So that's when I play it slowly. If I play it a little bit faster, you'll start to hear how they get shorter, but you can still kind of tell. And then at tempo.
Mm-hmm.
etc. So you can do that even when you're playing it, obviously not that fast. You want to be able to find those notes, circle them in your music. It's helpful to get you to remember which ones you've chosen. And then every time you practice with your metronome, practice holding those a little bit longer. Obviously, you're going to have to keep them in tempo, right? So let me give another demonstration here with my metronome. And how you do that without, you know, having to catch up with the metronome. You do play a little catch up, though. So it's a little bit out of rhythm, but ultimately, when you're playing without a metronome, it's, you know, you're not playing so much catch up so quickly. When I'm doing this here with the metronome now, I have to catch up before the next beat or the whole thing kind of falls apart, okay? All right, so then for the section, that's about sort of how to practice. You have to practice slowly, and you have to use these kind of Tarzan anchor notes. You don't have to call them Tarzan notes. Whatever you want to call them, they're anchor notes. They're places for your brain to rest, collect itself, and then move on. And then it's not really so much about constant notes. It's these notes between these pillars. All right, so, and then there's one section in the middle here, and they actually repeat it because it's so darn hard. It's nice to have two shots at it, I guess. And so this is this section, etc. The thing that you need to remember to do, because you're jumping over the break, is that you have to lock your embouchure. Now, this is kind of in conflict with some of the things that I've talked about in other videos, where you can have your embouchure a little bit more flexible and it moves, and it's all this head tilt stuff that I talk about. You can go check those out and see what I'm talking about. But in this instance, you kind of have to lock your embouchure in one place, or you're never going to be able to make it through all of these little leaps, especially at this speed. When you lock your embouchure, in this case, you want to lock your embouchure to the lower note. Now, as I talk about, each note has a slightly different voicing, a slightly different embouchure, and a slightly different position on the mouthpiece itself with regard to your head. Here, you want to actually voice the lower note. If I were to do this slow, see how I'm moving? That would be as if I were playing it slowly. You can't do that when you're going fast because you'd be like all over the place. So you would have to, you lock it to the lower embouchure. Etc. So you want to make sure that it's nothing is moving here, because otherwise you're going to kind of lose it. So grip the sides of the mouth with the corners of your mouth. Grip the sides of the mouthpiece with the corners of your mouth and just hang on. Also here, it's these anchor notes are incredibly important, right? So if you would just play this as one passage, you know, you may get it 50% of the time. And I guess that's about it. So practice with your metronome, and we'll see you in another video. Thanks.